Hello everyone, today I will be showing you everything new with the Eye of the Storm update. Now this update is the best we have had in a long time. There's not that much stuff in it, but the stuff that is in it is so good. After you assemble the Celestial Tribute Tinny, your knights will be replaced by Full Moon Knights, basically meaning that you can see during the night time. It's pretty good change. But after you do that, if you check your map, you can see these little swirly things. Now, I recommend you check out this part for yourself, if you don't want spoilers, because the way this update is designed is that you can probably figure this all out by yourself. It's just that well made. But anyways, once you reach here, it's kind of hard to see. It has the same sandstorm effect, which makes you move slower. Somewhere in here, you'll find, oh my god, Wagstaff, don't starve. That's right. He has come here from Hamlet not as a playable character, but as just an NPC. This basically confirms that he's not going to be coming as a playable character, because it would be pretty weird if you could play as Wagstaff and then encounter yourself. But anyways, he says a few things, he drops two blueprints. One of them lets you craft a hat that lets you see in this storm. At this point, you're gonna have to start following him. He kinda teleports around everywhere like a hologram. And eventually, he'll find this little box tinny. Don't hit it. Don't destroy it. That's a bad idea. Instead, you have to guard him from all these weird birds that try and attack him. While this is all going on, you have to hand him tools that spawn around him. And this whole side quest part of the update is so cool. I don't think we've seen something like this ever. And the fact that they added it, it's so good. After you finish this fun minigame thing, you get the orb thing you was working on, which becomes a very key component later on. Now, what you have to remember from this storm place is that you can mine the lunar rocks, and you can catch the moon gleams with a net. You need these items to craft the new spawner, which will summon the new boss. It's kind of a pain to get them. My one gripe with this update is that it's really grindy to get this all. But once you do, it's worth it, because this boss fight is amazing. Before I get into that though, I just want to quickly say to avoid Dragonfly during this update, because she kinda crashes your game. And for some reason, she leads you to my Ruins Rush video, which is pretty cool. Anyways, this boss, in my opinion, is by far the best one. Like, I genuinely believe that this is my favorite boss in all of Don't Starve. Unlike a lot of raid bosses in this game, there's no dumb mechanics, there's no little minions they spawn, they don't trap you in cages and just generally annoy you. It's just a one-on-one fight. He fights you, you fight him, and one of you make it out alive. He has three phases and a bunch of different attacks in these phases. The boss fight itself is awesome. It's fair, it feels like you can actually win it the first time you fight it, it's just great. After you do defeat him in his three phases, the moon cycle will actually reset. The whole world turns into nighttime for a day, and that day marks the new moon. And that's basically everything new with the sub-day. Like I said at the start, there's not that much new with it, but the stuff that does come is a very good boss fight that's far above the rest in this game. I've seen a lot of people complain about it, but in my opinion, it's just great. It's a bit of a short video, but I just thought I had to get it out there. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.